Council meetings are long and boring. Wouldn't it be great if they were short and unboring? This is why I have invented the 5-minute meeting. All right, Ashland City Council meeting of August 18th. This one too sick to Zoom this week. So there you go, not there. A COVID emergency declaration discussion off the bat. The city guy says, another month, please, of that. And then this guy says, Zoom, allow the citizens to Zoom in at commission meetings. The city guy goes, oh, yeah, that, we started doing that one. And then this one says, hey, other cities have implemented things more like that. And how come we're a little behind on that? And the city guy goes, oh, no, we got some of that stuff that's going to happen tonight. We got some people coming in, zooming in. And then this guy goes, and the regular public forum, people want that back. What's our plan there? And the city goes, oh, well, we're thinking about working towards moving in that direction for sure. And then bingo. Not too sick to Zoom. She's back in. And they all agreed. Emergency declaration continued another month. And then the city administrator's report. Utility billing is working with the United Way and Access to provide assistance to people hurting from the pandemic, of course, and behind on payments. They're working with a bunch of people on that. And there's an evacuation study being paid for by a grant that is happening right now. And that's evacuation, like how to drive out of town in an emergency routes. Evacuation and that's gonna be ready by Thanksgiving. And then the fire department got 500 air purifiers, and they've already spread 480 of those around town for free. And then this one says, he goes, hey, the city guy, the Aura, they got money too for the poor people hurting from COVID. You've been talking to them too, right? And then the city guy goes, I'm not certain what their deal is. And he goes, well, why don't you just go check that out? And he's like, all right. And then the consent agenda came along, and they have to approve that. And then, the big part of most of the meeting. The appeal of the Alicia Street 12-unit cottage housing project. It's on Alicia Street, as you might have met. Now, see, this guy stumbled painfully through the next 2 hours of this process. And the number of exasperated eye rolls from the other members of the Zoom, more than two dozen. So just imagine that happened constantly throughout the rest of this meeting. So city guy says the city's fine with this project and the planning commission did everything right. And so all the neighbors who hated this project because they don't want 12 houses jammed into every 2-acre lot in town, they had to approve that the planning commission was evil or drunk or something. And so they had to raise five specific technical complaints, but the city guy refuted them all on blabberty technical bureaucratic rules and explanations and dismissive code recitations. And the city guy said, screw those complainers, this project is technically code and ordinance wise legal. And then this guy goes, maybe we should check on the sewer lines more. And the city attorney goes, that's not part of the discussion. And this one goes, no, that seems like a pretty reasonable request. The city guy goes, legally is not our problem. And then this guy goes, He goes, I know it's technically not an issue legally, but checking the sewer lines seems like, and the attorney goes, I don't care. Rules are we legally don't have to check those lines, sewer lines. And then the cottage builder lady representative, she said, like the city said, we followed all the cottage housing rules and we agree with the planning commission who approved us. And then the official anti-cottage housing guy, he says infill is being done poorly and public input process is terrible and the cottage ordinance is just jammed down our throat. And then this guy goes, hey, city attorney, should I tell him to stop talking now? And city attorney went, no, he's fine, he's just talking. And then there's some public comment. So public comment lady zoomed in and she said, we want this project to be compatible with our neighborhood. And then a public comment guy said he didn't understand the whole rules and he didn't understand Zoom and he wanted more time and he had petitions and he wanted all the houses to be the same size as his, and he was certain that he's declared that everyone was going to die if there was a fire. And then there's a second public comment guy, and he said fire access, flooding issues, and public process are all big problems here. The second guy made some good points, actually. And then the city attorney says, the only thing that council can decide is, was the planning commission fair? That's it. And then this guy goes, all the ticky-tacky rules of this process is pissing off our citizens, and I don't blame them, so we have to change this process. And this guy said, that's how the cow ate the cabbage. It was a new one for me. And then they moved to approve all of, approve the process, disprove the appeal. So all the neighbors who came up with these 5 points, they went through the 5 points and went, they're fine, it's fine, it's fine. And so approved the cottage housing projects approved on Alicia Street, and then they moved to approve the tourism money to be spent. That's $80,000 spent on 13 local groups who are doing stuff. And then the city manager job description and recruiting process came up, and the city lady in charge of that said, "You guys want to start that now or later? I mean, you know, what are you thinking? You know, we could do a couple of different ways." And this one goes, "Hey, let's start the recruiting in January when all the new council's in." But we'll keep working on the job description and the job requirements in the meantime. And then they voted yes in some way on that. But then they ran out of time. And before they got into talking about the job description, they voted to finish talking about it in the next meeting. And I don't know if that's the whole thing or just the job description. It went way over, ran out of time. Thank God it ended. It's the end of meeting. You're welcome.